Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video we will discuss about the statistical computing, and this video is the introduction of statistical computing. So let's start. So why we are studying this? Because the discipline of stats deals with the collection of, analysis, interpretation of data. And in computers, we are studying statistical computing because the long calculations, large number of calculations are not done, we are not able to done with hands. So we use statistical computing or computers for managing that data or making the estimates of data. So the first chapter is probability distribution. In this distribution, there is random variables, or if we say about where we used the statistical computing, in for example the effectiveness of new vaccine AIDS, or agronomist may want to decide if an increase in yield and can be attributed to new strain of wheat. Meteorologist may be interested in predicting whether it is going to rain or particular day, or an environmentalist may be interested in testing whether a new controls can lead to decrease in the pollution level, or economists' interest may lie in estimating the unemployment rate, or stats and probabilistic foundation on which statistical method are based can provide the model that may be used to make decision in this. Many other situations involve uncertainty. So for probability or decide the future or future predictions, we use statistical computing. So let's start. In this video I will give you only a basic intro, and by the second video we will study this in detail. So what are random? If you think about the random, the things which are coming randomly, we don't know about in advance. So random experiment or statistical experiment in any act whose outcome cannot be predicted in advance. Any outcome or random experiment is known as an event. So for example, the number of telephone calls received by Monica, we don't know about it in advance. Or time to fail a machine, or the outcome of rolling dice. So these are all included in random variables. So random variables are of two types. So let's see. Discrete random variable and continuous random variable. In discrete, we define discrete random variable. Let's take an example for explaining this. For example, you have purchased a new battery or a wristwatch and you want inserted in one new battery into it. Suppose you are interested in the following: how long will it before the first battery needs replacement, and how many battery will have to be replaced during one period. So here we are talking about the two conditions: how long will it to before, or the first needs replacement, or how many battery will have to be replaced during 1 year period. So the variable takes value continuously along a line, say from the duration A to duration B. No values in between A and B are left out. In other words, there is no break in the value assumed in this variable for the question how long will it before first needs battery replacement. So continuous use of that battery, when it will finish, then we will need another battery. So it's a continuous variable. And let's take second condition: how many battery will have to be replaced during 1 year period. There is no continuity since only non-negative integer value can be assumed. So the range of this variable is discrete set of points. From this discussion it is clear that the random value x to define in example 1 is discrete random variable. So let's go to another topic: binomial distribution and Poisson distribution. These are the types of discrete variable. And when we talk about the binomial, the only very important discrete random variable is the binomial distribution. In this quite often we have to deal with experiments where there are only two possible outcomes. For example, if you are tossing the coins, either you get tail or you could get head. So it's the example of binomial distribution. So let's go to Poisson distribution. In this we shall describe the different situation where we can apply the Poisson distribution. Suppose it is first hour in a bank, busy Monday morning, and we are interested in the number of customer who might arrive during that hour, during 5 minute or 10 minute interval in that hour. In stats terms, we want to find the probability for the number of arrival in a certain time interval frame. So this is Poisson distribution. Then come to continuous random variable. Continuous random variable, we already discussed about this type of random variable which can take uncountably many values is called continuous random variable. So let's discuss about uniform. The uniform distribution is the simplest of a few well-known continuous distributions which occur quite often. It can be explained intuitively very easily. Suppose x is a continuous random variable such that if we take any subinterval of sample space, then the possibility that x belongs to this subinterval is the same as the probability x belongs to any other subinterval the same. So the distribution corresponding this random variable is known as uniform distribution. This random is called uniform random variable. So let's go to exponential random variable. So in making the mathematical model for a real world phenomena, it is always necessary to make certain simplifying assumptions so as to render the mathematical tractability. On the other hand, however, we cannot make too many simplifying assumptions, for then our conclusion obtained from mathematical model not be applicable to real world. So in short, we must take enough simplifying assumptions to enable us to handle mathematics, but not so that mathematical model no longer resembles the real world. So it's exponential random variable. A continuous random variable is said to be exponential random if probability distribution function of x is given sum is x is greater than 0. Okay. So let's go to normal distribution. Normal distribution is undoubtedly the most used continuous distribution in different areas such as astronomy, biology, psychology, and of course probability statistics too. The work of Gauss in 1809-1816 based on the normal distribution, which became standard method used during the 19th century. Because of Gauss' enormous contribution, it is also popularly known as Gauss distribution. So the last one is, and here we are standardizing or calculating the probabilities. Let's discuss about chi-square distribution. The chi-square distribution can be obtained from normal distribution as follows. Suppose z1, z2, zn till zn. So the degree of freedom here basically indicates the number of independent components which constitute chi-square distribution. It has received a great deal of attention because of its appearance in constructing analysis of variable tables. So it's very important because in exam, chi-square distribution sometimes come in exam. I have observed the questions of last 10 years. The chi square mostly come in exam for short notes. You can study in detail in my next videos. It's a statistical distribution, second chapter, pseudo random number generation. Pseudo random number generation we can do by hand also, but pseudo random generation is the methodology to develop algorithm and programs that can be used in probability and stats applications when large quantities of random digits are needed. So most of these programs produce endless strings of single digit number, usually in base 10, known as a decimal system. When large sample of pseudo random numbers are taken, each of the 10 digits in the set 0 to 9 occurs with equal frequency, even though they are not even distributed in the sequence. So this is all about the pseudo random number generator. Let's discuss about uniform random number generator. Uniform random number generators. It is very important to have very good uniform random numerator. There are several methods available for generating uniform random number, but currently the most popular is LCG. It is written in book, but we have to find out currently which method is using. So we will discuss in detail about the current method in our next video, coming videos. So let's discuss about generating random variable from arbitrary distribution. So simulation that has any random aspects at all must involve generating random variate from different distribution. We usually use the phrase generating a random variate to refer to the activity of obtaining observation or realization of random variable from desired distribution. These distributions are often specified as a result of fitting some appropriate distribution form. They are often specified in advance, for example, exponential gamma, Poisson. So, we will read this in our coming videos because this is the intro video. We can't cover whole topic in detail. Inverse transform. We want to generate a random variable x that has a continuous and strictly increased distribution function f. So, when 0 is less than fx or less than 1, whenever x1 is less than x2, then fx1 less than fx2, we draw a curve of f in the figure 1. So let f1 denote the inverse of function f. Then an algorithm for generating a random variable x having distribution function f is as follows. So algorithm here is step 1, generate u1 from u1, 0, 1, and step 2, return x1, f1 and 0, 1. You can see this the diagram in your book. So let's go to acceptance rejection method. This is the last topic of this chapter. The inverse transformation method to generate random number from different non-uniform distribution. Note that apparently the inverse transformation method seems to be the most general method for generating random variable from any distribution functions. In fact, it can be used provided distribution function can be written in explicit form or may more precisely. The inverse of the distribution function can be computed analytically. For example, in case of exponential, variable, Cauchy distribution, the distribution function also their inverse can be constructed analytically. So, now let's go to third chapter. And third chapter is regression analysis. The statistical computing is related to data probability. So this is, if you are thinking about where we can implement this. So we can implement this in a Python language or machine learning. This is very useful or for data analysis. So I think you can relate this with Python if you already know Python or you are using Python. So let's discuss about simple linear regression. First, discuss about why we are doing regression analysis. Is a statistical technique for modeling or investigating the relationship between two or more variables. Here we are investigating the relationship between two or more variables. For example, regression analysis can be used to build model that express yield function of temperature. This model can be used to predict yield at a given temperature level. Can also be used for process optimization or process control. So, simple linear regression. This is very easy. We wish to determine the relationship between single regression variable x and y response variable. So we refer to y and dependent variable or response x and independent variable regression. So first is set response and second is regression. The regression variable x is assumed to be continuous variable controlled by the experiment. So this is looking a very boring because here is no example, no diagrams. But in our coming videos, we will study with examples, graphs, or lots of calculations are here. So let's go to least square estimation. Suppose that we have an n pair of observation x1 and y1, xn and yn. It is assumed that the observed y1 and x1 satisfy a linear relation as given in the model. So these data can be used to estimate the unknown parameter of β0 or β1. So method we are going to use here is known as the method of least squares, that is well estimated by β0 or β1, so that the sum of squares of the derivation from observation to the regression line is minimum. So now come to goodness of fit. Goodness of fit or least square estimation or residual analysis comes in the exam as a short note also. So goodness of fit, we have seen in the previous section that the regression line provide estimates of dependent variable for a given value of independent value. So regression line is called the best fitted line in the sense of minimizing the sum of square errors. So best fitted line shows the relationship between independent x or dependent y variable better than any other method. So question arises, how good is your best fitted line? So we want measure of this goodness of fit, more precisely we want numerical value which measures this goodness of fit. Now residual analysis. Fitting a regression model to a set of data requires several assumptions. For example, estimation of model parameters requires assumption that errors, unrelated random input and mean with mean zero and constant variance. If these assumptions are not satisfied, then using a simple least squares method may not produce the efficient regression line. In fitting a linear model, it is also assumed that the order of the model is correct. That if we fit a first order polynomial, then we are assuming that the phenomenon actually behaves in a first order manner. So therefore, for practitioner, it is important to verify these assumptions and adequacy of model. So we define the residuals as you can see in detail in our coming videos. With the graphs, you can better understand. Non-linear regression. Linear regression is a widely used method of analyzing data described by models which are linear in parameters. However, in many practical situations, people come across data where the relation between independent variable and dependent variable is not linear. In that case, definitely one should not try to use linear regression model to represent the relationship between. So the independent and dependent variable, let us consider the example in a coming video. Or in non-linear, there is a least square estimation. So similar to linear regression method, here to estimate the unknown parameters, we adopt the same method. We calculate the estimate of zero, estimate of theta by minimizing the residues of sums of squares, that is minimized. So that's all. Thanks for watching.